preparación. Escucha mi canción mientras yo le doy jalón a la mota.
Go ahead and introduce yourself, man, those that don't know.
My name is Kiki Smooth. My name is Kiki Smooth, the first Mexican rapper out of Compton.
Man, long overdue, man, and I sincerely apologize, man. We've been hearing about you for years, dog, like years and years, dog, and you're one of the cats that just fell through, man. Like, man, this fool's doing more shit, and we're like, man, how come we haven't got him up in here, man? So long overdue. Apologies from me, first of all.
Hey,
you know,
man,
what I mean?
I don't even care how long it took. Like I told my peoples, I even told my girl, it's an honor for me to come tonight.
Shit,
I don't even
man.
Give a fuck, man. You know, write or stand up, nigga. What you write? That's what I feel. You know what I'm saying? For an MC like me to respect the first, you know, part of hip hop is DJing, you know, graffiti, breakdancing, and I represent all of those things.
Yeah, you're heavily influenced. Not just influenced, but your roots are in that, though, right?
Yes, definitely. You know, I'm from California, but goddamn it, you know, piecing and bombing and tagging and spray painting and, you know, art comes in every city. And, you know, like I tell people, when you come to L.A., you got to come to Compton. Like when you go to New York, you got to go to the Bronx.
Yep.
You feel me? And that's just what it is with us, you know. Compton and Watts, you know, they got beautiful pieces out there. You know what I'm saying? I got my niggas from Watts with me, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, who's on the tables, man? We got to give shout-outs first.
You know,
shout-out
to my producer. One of my producers, John Henry, Shovelin Hammer Click. You know what I'm saying? Like, this dude took me under his wing on another level. And like, come on, my dog.
What is the Shovel and Hammer, man? Is that different from Kiki Smooth? Is it the same thing? What is it?
Everything I do is going to be Kiki Smooth. Shovel and Hammer is actually like our baby, right? It's the army.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's the heart. It's the heart in Kiki Smooth.
So what is it? Producers, MCs? What is
it? Yeah, it's producers, MCs, you know, singers, musicians, you know. It's John shit. John needs a mic over there because it's really, I joined the army.
Okay.
I realized that John needed a hitman and a sniper, and I wanted to feel that. I don't want to be a general. Feel me? That ain't my job. I'm just here to do hits. Feel me?
KikiSmooth.com.
Definitely.
You've been grinding, man, and then you got some work. You did some work with YELLA. What's the work you did with YELLA?
Oh, I got 3 mixtapes coming out. We got one out, you know what I'm saying? CPT mixtape. It was a blessing, you know?
And for those that if you speak of Compton and don't know who DJ YELLA is, I don't know what else. You're on the wrong motherfucking station.
Like,
you're in the wrong
spot.
Said on you know
that
what
song,
I mean?
Like I said on that song, I couldn't find Dre, but I went and found YELLA.
But here's the shit, and I don't think people like don't know, but I need you to tell the story on how the connect came for Kiki Smooth from Compton to link up with you. It was easy because like you just walked down the street, right? Or you just walked out.
check it out.
Real shit. And this some real shit.
Homie Chopper from 155. I'm from Compton on another level. I know every nigga, but this dude believes in me. He used to be my record boy. He told me, I'm taking you to Oxnard City, all right, for a signing with YELLA. We're just going to wait in line. You should show him your music. Nah, I don't want to go. I want to smoke weed. Nah, we're going to go. We went. Took that hour and a half drive. We get there. There's a line longer than county line. I told that nigga, fuck that. He said, nah, we already came here. We're the last motherfuckers there.
Okay.
He said, well, now you got time to think about what the fuck you're going to tell him, because if that nigga don't call you, by the time we go home, you're going to get boo-bop. I went there, and it took 2 blunts and a beer for me to kick it there, but yeah, I did. And we waited 2 hours, bro.
Damn.
Like real fans. And, you know, I told myself, this is your moment. Yeah. Are you going to tell him how much you love him as a DJ or how much he needs you as an MC?
So we know how that shit went.
I practice this motherfucking speech every day on the mirror. I know it sounds funny, but it's real, dog.
Yeah.
When you get to these moments, they don't come. It, like, a lot. Yeah, it's up to you.
You know, I want you to. I wanted you to tell that story because, like, cats don't be believing that shit. You know what I mean? Like,
nah, that shit.
You was
real.
On something like, nah, 2 hours.
Nah,
I stood in
I waited. Then look, you know what? After all that, me and my nigga Caesar, we kicked it with the guy that acted as Eazy-E. And Jella took us to the movie set and the whole shit. Right? Me and my nigga Caesar doing it. The nigga told me what he waited like 7 hours.
Damn.
Then they didn't call him for like 2 months. Then they flew him to L.A. Didn't call him for a year.
So you knew that this takes
so
time.
Yes, that's when I started understanding and like what's happening now. That's why I'm glad I'm here today.
Yeah, because if anybody tuning in right now is just like, oh yeah, this dude's just kicking up dust. Nah, dog, you've been like years,
man,
dog.
I've been trying to get here on this couch for years. This is hip hop to me, bro.
Yeah.
You feel me? I'm a rider. Feel me? Like, I tell y'all that, man. I'm a real rider, man. Like, I love hip hop for what it is.
I have to.
Graffiti is part of that. People forget that. Graffiti is a big part of hip hop, my nigga.
It's been a big part for us, shit. Part of our success, shit.
Hey, dog, like, all I gotta say is this, man. Like, the dude that got me here is my nigga Devo from KCC. And when I reached out to him, it was for one reason. When I was in junior high, I would walk those alleys through Compton.
Yeah.
And his brother, Skull, rest in peace, will have these pieces through these alleys. And then I would go home and my auntie had cable, so we would see Yo MTV Raps, and I'm seeing pieces on the videos.
Go ahead and check the archives. Hey. OG Husky Radio, the Devo KCC interview, man. That's some history.
Yeah, man, that dude, OG's, man, that's my boy right there.
So, you know, it can't be all just love and easy interview, dog. I had to, you know, I got to put the questions out there, man. You already know. You know about us.
Hey,
so
man.
Then, musically, would you consider yourself a Chicano rapper?
Nah.
Why not?
Are
you a Chicano?
I'm from Compton, California. No, I'm Mexican.
You're Mexican?
Yes. I'm not from East Los. I'm from Compton, California.
And what's
the
difference?
Bro.
What's the difference?
The difference is that my neighbor was black.
Yeah. Real shit.
And his neighbor was Mexican.
Yeah.
He was not Chicano. He was Mexican. And my mama from Guerrero, Mexico. Sube los zapatistas, baby.
Hell yeah. Shout out to Easy Allen.
All right, man. I'm just going to let y'all know.
Yeah.
And that's why Cam put me on his single, too. Because he understands that my mama and my family roots, they come real. Feel me? We real. From all the way from Guerrero, from Compton, people know La Chole. Reals. Yeah. And that's mama, my nigga. And my mom knows they represent. You know what I'm saying? We real warriors. Feel me? And I can never represent something that ain't me. Feel me? I was raised on, how can you say, Menudo and Gumbo.
Sure shit.
Feel
Damn.
Me? My next door neighbor got raised on fried chicken and tacos.
Straight up.
You feel me?
Yeah.
And that's what I'm here.
And
I'm
that's why I put the question
bridge.
Out there. No,
I'm
that we could put that out there. That's why I want.
You
I have
know,
to ask
and,
that.
And like today, I was telling the homies, I've never had this many blessings in my life since, like, Cam, Jella, Glasses, all second to none. All these dudes are starting to come call me.
Yeah.
And I'm the Mexican out of Compton that's been trying to show them that we are here.
Yeah.
Feel me? We here. Because, it, like I told you, when you go to New York, you want to go to the Bronx. And when you want come to L.A., you got to go to Compton and watch. You have to.
So then, you were a B-boy.
Definitely.
Before.
In Compton.
In Compton. Before you were an MC?
Definitely.
Yeah.
And a graffiti artist.
So where did that transition come from? What made
that,
you turn?
That,
go to
that was the turntables. That was the turntables.
Yeah, because we got to get you back, dog, because people don't know you could rock the tables,
I,
too.
Yeah, I worked at you know, Eazy-E's record store. Shout out to Big A, Underworld Records. You know what I'm saying? I toured all around the world with Coolio. I was Coolio's DJ for 5 years. You know, he showed me the blessings of how to be on stage. So when y'all see me on stage, I don't come just to rock. Like today, my man put me on blast. Feel me? I even forgot the second verse on the fucking first song. I'm going to keep it real. It's real hip hop, but I'm a great entertainer.
Yeah.
You feel me? And that's what Coolio taught me, touring 5 years around the world. You feel me? I got passports.
So
man.
Like hip hop is not it's a lifestyle. It's not just
to me it's what I do. Feel me? I don't understand what people like consider hip hop in their life.
Yeah.
But to me, I consider hip hop as much as Gangstar all the way to Digital Underground. All the way from let's say N.W.A. to the Humpty Dance. You feel me? To me, everything, Young MC, everything is hip-hop to me. I don't discourage the non-lyrics part.
Yeah.
You feel me? Because if it makes you dance, and that means the soul speaking.
Yeah.
You know, like hip-hop is based on soul. That's what makes you move. The words connect to your soul.
You don't have to answer it, and I'm just, I have to ask though, but like, why is there not a Mexican successful commercial rapper? Radio.
It's because I've been taking long, man. I like smoking weed.
Hell yeah, that's the fuck I'm talking about.
And like, I'll be drinking. Yeah, you know, like my girl got to pick me up sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, like I don't like driving. But
That's the fuck I'm talking about. KikiSmooth.com, motherfuckers. KikiSmooth.com.
We're getting there, though, bro.
Yeah.
I swear to you, we're getting there. Like Yella told me. Man, that nigga, that everybody's telling me, like, keep working hard. To me today, sitting on this couch is telling me I'm doing it.
Yeah, you've been, like I said, you've been, dog.
Like, I'm just letting y'all know, like, I do it all. Feel me? To me, hip-hop is all. You feel me? Commercial, whatever it is. You know, like, I'm from Compton, California. Google it.
Growing up, because we're broadcasting live from East Los, it's all raza, straight up. Is there, like, the tensions that are sold to us in Compton between races on some real shit? Because you're time
it depends what set you from.
Yeah. So it's not so racial.
I grew up in a Crip neighborhood, and all the Crips love us because my mama was the Coke lady. But, you feel me?
Yeah.
But if you grew up in a Blood neighborhood, then all the Bloods
Hold the mic up. All
the Bloods might be fucking with you, maybe not. It depends on who you are in that.
But it's not racial for the sense that it's racial that it's so
I mean, shit, everybody's racial.
Yeah.
Man, fuck that white person. Or fuck that Asian nigga. Oh, man, you know what? What's the Mayate doing over here? It's the same shit, my nigga.
Yeah.
But it's like, who are you close to?
Yeah.
Is the question.
Okay.
You feel me? Like, you got to understand, I live this, my nigga. So for you to say, is it racial? It's racial for me to say that I don't like the dude from that street. And if he comes and shoot at me, maybe my nigga's going to jump at you too.
Yeah.
You feel me? And that's just what it is where you're at. You know what I'm saying?
Straight up.
It ain't where you're from, it's what you do in it.
Straight up. No, part of doing this is that we're reaching out to the broad spectrum of what it is. Yeah, we're in East Los. Yeah, it's hood. But yeah, Compton. But just an understanding for people outside of it. Because all they're seeing is the negativity.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
What you don't understand this is that right now in life, if you go to the jungle, you're going to find a lion that wants to bite you.
That's the dopest shit I've ever heard, dog.
But you can still go on a tour. But that happens for me in East Los, too.
Yeah.
It's right.
The
environment. I'm not from out here. Yeah. Right? If I ain't with the right people, something can happen to me because I'm not talking like y'all.
Straight up.
Right?
Yeah.
So some people would be like, hey, homie, why you talking like these Mayates and all that and all this? And I tell them, because, motherfucker, I'm from Compton and Watts. Nigga, I opened the front door and there's Compton. I jumped the back gate and it's Watts. Nice. Feel me? And if y'all don't believe it, the tower's right in front of my mama house.
Yeah.
My man live in Compton.
KikiSmooth.com. Give him the Instagram, all the other content.
Yeah, KikiSmooth. It's just KikiSmooth.
KikiSmooth. KikiSmooth.
Look, first Mexican out of Compton. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real, look. Shout outs to Black Rose Entertainment, Overtime Hustling Magazine. You know, like, these are my peoples. We run deep. Rascone Entertainment. You know, that's my label. Look, what I'm telling y'all right now is Shovel and Hammer is coming on another level. All right? John Henry is the producer that y'all been looking for in East Los.
Straight up.
All right? When this man can take the MPC and bring an orchestra into it, it's another level. All right? You have Compton in the east side together. Alright? Because I'm from the east side of Compton anyways, nigga.
That's the same, right?
So I'm just letting y'all know, for every MC out there, don't think that he won't fuck with y'all. I told him I can't keep it to myself.
Oh, so willing to work.
John Henry's the illest. I'm telling y'all
what
now.
Does Shovel and Hammer mean? What's
it,
a shovel
it means that he be digging in them crates.
Oh.
And then if you a real MC, you can hammer them down.
Straight up, man. Y'all some hip hop shit, dog.
Yeah. I'm just letting y'all know. Yeah, Record Jungle. Yeah. Record Jungle, that's my boy. He works there. You feel me? Real vinyl.
Word up.
Feel me? So I'm just letting y'all know. samples. That dude got them for days, bro. And then we break them down to the orchestra. Shovel and Hammer Dog, you know, shouts to Richard Wright, shouts to Coco, shouts to Willie, shouts to Alex, shouts to John Henry, you know.
What's the next project for you, man?
I'm dropping the next Yella CD. We're dropping the Shovel and Hammer. We're dropping can we play a world premiere?
Let's drop it. Let's close it out with it, man. Yeah, as he digs it out.
This is Ghetto Boy, Shovel and Hammer. Featuring TJ Gibson, he wrote Robin Thicke's album. That nigga got Grammys up the booty. Yeah. And we've been blessed to work with him. Feel me? This dude is like a rock and roll guy that doesn't mess with nobody.
Hold on. I got to write. What's the name of this track?
TJ. This is called Ghetto Boy. Little Ghetto Boy. Little Ghetto Boy.
And what's the artists are?
TJ Gibson and Kiki Smooth, produced by Shola Hammer, John Henry.
Word up. OGSQ Radio.
This is world premiere. No one ever is.
Well, then let's not talk through it then, dog shit.
Exclusive, all right. I know that. I just wanted to spit some bars before I leave, because it's been a blessing being here.